All right, that was Rick James with Glow. All right, trying to get my shit together over here. I'm hearing sounds and certain things. Can y'all hear me pretty good? Hold on. Okay. All right, just making sure everything is right. How y'all doing, man? Y'all know what it is. Ready to chop up game on tonight's show. Let me see what's going on here. I'm trying to do some things here. Hold on 1 second, family. Hold on. Y'all bear with me 1 second. Trying to get some things going. Hold on 1 second. Bear with me. All right. The phone number is 818-850-5404. You dig? 818-850-5404, that is the number. Man. All right, so we got a lot to cover tonight. Tonight's going to be a good show. It's going to be a good show tonight. Tonight is going to be a damn good show. Let me let y'all know in advance. It's going to be a great show tonight. We already got moderators in the room. We got Kiki Naturalista, she's a mod. Natural Charm is a mod. Lex Noir is a mod. Miss Braxton is a mod. Mr. Ola is a mod. Ola, I got to call you, man. I saw you call me the other day, Ola, and I've been meaning to call you. I was down in San Diego this weekend, went to the San Diego Zoo with the family. Real nice. We had a good time down there. It's a lot of swirling down in San Diego. Boy, the swirl was heavy down there. So we went down there. Was it a squirrel convention? I don't know what the fuck was happening. Also, then when we were down there, they were having Comic-Con. It was a whole bunch of shit. It was like a gay pride parade. So it was a bunch of dudes in the hotel with flip-flops. I didn't know what was going on. Shout out to them. You know, live your truth, goddammit. Live your damn truth. Oh, nigga. San Diego. I ain't seen that kind of swirling before. Man, I'm all right. All right, San Diego. Oh, man. So, man, on what are you talking about, Joey Dangerously? These helicopters. So, we got a lot of good stuff going. I'm getting my own video streaming page where people can just go to my page directly and I'm going to be able to stream videos. Shout out to my dude, my web guy, Randall. Shout out to him as a damn hair by. But shout out to Randall. I got to test one of the pages that he sent. So we're working on that now. Because as we know, you know, YouTube, a lot of the white supremacists, they are, you know, going around flagging shit. And, you know, I've already known that they were going to do that. So I try to stay 3 or 4 steps ahead. So I've been working on getting my own independent channel, just like with the Tariq Radio page. When I started doing my podcast, I would host it on different sites. And I started learning something. I started learning that my podcast, when I did Mac Lessons Radio, I started to learn that I would get on these pages that would host podcasts, which were relatively new, around a decade ago. But I noticed that my show was getting high ratings than everybody else's. And I was generating a lot of income for these pages. And they didn't want to break bread. I'm bringing in a lot of advertising dollars for them. So I'm like, let me get my own independent site. So then I did Mac Lessons Radio, which was his own independent site. It got millions of hits on that site. And I can control it, so nobody could censor what the hell I was saying, which was cool. I relatively recently just started posting stuff on YouTube, just because so many other people were posting my stuff on YouTube. So I'm like, let me post my own stuff. So with YouTube now, a lot of people post my stuff or make videos about me because that brings hits and clicks. But YouTube has never been a primary income for me. I mistakenly made money on YouTube. I didn't even know I made money on this shit. I would look into the account and there'd be like 10,000 here, 15,000. I'm like, oh, cool. All right. How'd I get that? That's just little surprise money that would pop up. So that wasn't no real money that I'm tripping on. And I'm not like some of these YouTube coons who gotta basically live off that. But again, I want to have, and I'm going to have, my own streaming page where I can go all the way in. Now, I'm going to still have a couple of YouTube pages to bring everybody to the new stuff. You dig? Are the trolls in here? Shout out to the trolls. I know y'all in here. I'm going to get on you trolls in a minute. I'm going to get on you trolls in a minute. Yeah, man, because I had a lot of videos that I didn't even know they were monetized, and I just never collected the money because I wasn't even tripping on it. Then I just happened, because, you know, people are like, man, open up a Google AdSense account. And for me, I'm like, what the fuck is that? So I just opened one up just to open it up, and they were like, you can monetize videos. Again, I don't know about all that shit. So I'm like, okay, you know how YouTube gives you the option. Do you want to monetize your video? I'm like, yeah, sure. Then I just never check on it. I don't be like looking at that little money. Then I just happen to look into the AdSense account, like $15,000. Okay, cool. Okay, I'll throw that in the mix. But that ain't no real money, though. Not for real. I mean, I'm not trying to shit on money because there's people who need it, but yeah, surprise money. Now, I'm not shitting on any money because we don't know nobody's situation. You don't know where they are. That could be a life changer. You dig? But that extra stream of revenue, you know, that never hurts. But I don't like when motherfuckers try to censor my shit. Then it's time to start getting my own joint popping. You dig? It's time to get your own joint popping. And that's what I'm doing. A lot has gone on lately. Did you guys get a chance to see the Planet of the Apes movie? I told people to go see that. Some people were like, man, the description you made, because on my last podcast, I did a description of the Planet of the Apes, and I talked about how the movie is basically about white genocide. That's really the allegory, because so many folks were, many of the suspected white supremacists were talking about it wasn't about race, and that whole thing with D-Ray and the vest. All of that was about Black Lives Matter. The whole movie, it was about white genetic survival. It was a white genocide, because that's what these white supremacists, they've been talking about, white genocide. And if you look at that movie, they were so blatant about it. Real talk, Ola. I mean, the movie, and I don't want to rehash what I talked about on Wednesday or Thursday, whenever I did the show, but the Planet of the Apes movie, they're like getting whipped. The apes are getting whipped like slaves. They're in a constant, I mean, the shit looked like a concentration camp that they were in. And the troops are doing these Nazi marches. I mean, look, we got to understand how white supremacy is. The name of the game, what's up from London? I'm not giving no spoilers. I don't want to give no spoilers. They even had some Underground Railroad type shit. Did y'all get that? It was some shit where it was like an Underground Railroad. The apes were going underground. I mean, the allegory was so blatant. And understand, I keep trying to tell you that the dominant society, they use movies to tell each other stories and codes. The coon apes were the funniest, though. And I'm not gonna give up the plot, but the coon apes were hilarious. Yeah, the apes who got out of line, the coon apes would whoop them. I mean, it was straight up on some slave allegory shit. But the coon apes were hilarious. Because when they caught that one coon ape, okay, where's my son? Go back in the house. Hold on one second. My son is outside. Hold on one second. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on, y'all bear with me. But yeah, the coon apes were hilarious. Yeah, they had the word donkey written on them. It was so blatant. And the coon apes were helping out the white troops and they caught one of the coon apes, and they hemmed him up a little bit, and the coon, and some of the apes talked, but some of them did sign language, and the coon ape was literally bucking his eyes and popping his lips. I'm sorry. Like, how'd they get the coon ape to buck his eyes? Ape, sorry. I had to do it to survive. Gotta get that body count down. Somebody said, well, you said the ape, one of the apes looked like Crispy. I don't know. I was waiting on the ape to do the coon laugh. I was waiting on the coon laugh from the ape. But go look at the movie, though. Go look at the movie, man. Learn the codes that they try to give out to each other. They'll try to shame us into not looking into the allegories of stories. That's their thing. They try to shame us. Oh, man, it's not like that. It's about this. Oh, stop race baiting. All that old bullshit. They work in codes. Oh, yeah, those coons, when they get around the white supremacists, boy, all teeth are showing. They all got a distinctive coon laugh. All of them got a coon laugh when they get around the white supremacists. But I'm going to talk a little bit about the alt-lice. That's what we call them, the alt-lice, and all that shit about the skeptic community. The white supremacists are constantly trying to rebrand themselves. The whole alt-right thing is them trying to rebrand themselves. Now that the alt-right, we know that they are nothing but a bunch of white supremacists, now they're trying to rebrand themselves into something else, the skeptic community. Many of these are the alt-right wannabes. So all of them are the alt-lice, as far as I'm concerned. Somebody said the skeptic community. And I got to touch on alt-lice Andy, which is Andrew Schultz. I got to get on his ass. I got to get on him first and foremost. Let me get on alt-right or alt-lice Andy. Now, for those who don't know, on when did I do the debate with alt-lice Andy? When did I do the debate with his bitch ass? Now, Charlamagne, me and Charlamagne are cool. But Andrew Schultz, that's Charlamagne's guy. They do the Brilliant Idiot Show. Says, stop sucking my teeth. I ate some damn Thai food and I ain't got no toothpick in here. That's why you keep hearing me suck my damn teeth. I'm sorry, Natural. But let me get on alt-lice Andy. Now, last week, we put up the suspected word database. Do you know these white supremacists and the alt-lice all lost their minds? They lost their minds when we put up the suspected word database. They lost their minds. And understand, the suspected words database, it wasn't accusing anybody of anything. The suspected words database was basically a site that questioned the validity of so-called free speech. So that's what it was really about. And nobody was being accused. We never called anybody a suspected white supremacist. Nothing. We just said it's a suspected words database. We're questioning words. We're questioning your free speech. And we had disclaimers. We're not accusing anybody of anything. And also, I didn't put anybody's name on there. I didn't put nobody on there. It was open for anybody. Anybody could have put whoever they wanted to put on there. So the site was up for about 30, 45 minutes. The site wasn't up that long at all. And people start putting names up there, and the white supremacists, boy, they start losing their minds. They were whining. Oh, you know, the symbol here is a swastika, which it's not. The symbol is not a swastika. It's not a swastika, but they were trying to use the I'm white and I say so. Philip, somebody put Phil DeFranco on there. He's talking about, oh my God, you're trying to get me killed. They went into full white supremacist, I'm scared of the Negro, I fear for my life mode. They went, that's their go-to. That I fear for my life. They went right into white supremacist mode. Oh my God, they're trying to, they put me on a hit list. Oh God, man. They're trying to put a hit on me, man. They went full white supremacist victim. You know, they putting extras on it. And the site got hacked immediately. Oh, they hacked it. They were putting all types of crazy shit on there. So the site is down. The site was completely hacked. The site is gone. The site has been so hacked up, chopped up, the whole shebang. Yeah, the site was hacked to oblivion. Oh, but they were, the fact that they, the thought of them being called out for any type of thing scared the shit out of them. Now, understand this. This was the suspected words database. There's other databases that list real white supremacists. I think the ACLU, they have a white supremacist database that names hate groups. They call them hate groups. So you got other lists out there that actually list white supremacists. But my thing is, I'm just talking about words. Nobody's calling anybody anything. We're just, anybody can list words. We're talking about your words. So the site got hacked, and somebody put Andrew Schultz's name on there. So Schultz called me. He called me, I think he left a message, and I called him back. I left him a message. Then he called me back. He was like, hey, man, my name is on the site, man. What's up? I'm like, well, yeah, I didn't put your name on there, man. But, you know, society, we're talking about suspected words. And he went into his whole thing with, man, I'm, you know, my life could be in danger, man. You know, the same shit Phil DeFranco was talking about, that whole my life is in danger. I'm like, look, man, look, the site is down. You dig? I didn't put your name on there, dude, which I didn't. And he was like, yeah, man, because, you know, it could be a thing of libel, you know. You know, the whole, my dad's a lawyer, dude. All that old bullshit. All right, I'm like, no, don't trip. Don't trip. And the site is down. Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do with it, but, you know, it is what it is. So, Schultz got on the show with Charlamagne. They did the show with Charlamagne, and Schultz was talking some real big shit. Schultz was talking like he called up like on some mafia boss shit. Schultz was talking like he called up on some mafia boss shit. Yeah, get that bullshit dude out of here, whoever's trolling. We're talking real game. But Schultz was talking some real rah-rah shit. And understand, I had a feeling that Schultz, that when he started talking that victim shit, oh, my life is in danger, I said, okay, he must be recording the call. He's looking for a reason to talk about this on his show. He's already laying the foundation, so I know he's going to talk about the call on his show. I already know it with all the extra dramatic, well, I'm in danger, man. I mean, somebody can target me. I'm like, okay, he's performing. Okay, he's performing. Here you go. All right. I was like, he's creating material for his show. All right? So he gets on the Brilliant Idiot Show. I mean, I'm going to play it while I'm talking. So this is him. And now, Andrew, now people have been saying that he's a full-out white supremacist for years. Y'all been saying that man, hey, Tariq, Andy is a fucking white supremacist. And I've never said he's a white supremacist. I'm just recently saying that I suspect of him of being one. Recently. I recently suspect him of being one. Because even when I was on his show, I've never called him a suspected white supremacist or white supremacist, but I really suspect him of being one because now he's leaning in. The number one tool of a white supremacist is deception. And all of those, the number two is denial of white supremacy. I mean, this motherfucker goes out of his way to deny white supremacy. So now he's doing his show with Charlamagne. Andrew Schultz has a full-out alt-right haircut now. I mean, this motherfucker has a haircut that looked like Richard Spencer. I mean, he got the Richard fucking Spencer neo-Nazi damn cut right now. Let me see if I can get a picture of it and if I can post one. But boy, Andy got the goddamn alt-right buzz cut. Let me see if I can give y'all a picture of it. Hold on. Y'all bear with me for 1 second. I'm going to get it. Hold on. Okay, here it is. Hold on. Let me post this up real quick. Let me post this motherfucker's haircut. And I told y'all, whenever I see these haircuts, I go on alert. Well, these white supremacists, they do little things to create identifiers for each other. Just like that old bullshit hand signal and all that. They do little things to act as identifiers for one another. All right, let me post this picture. Let me show y'all what I'm talking about so y'all don't think I'm just making up shit. I like to bring receipts. Okay, so this is Alt-Life Andy's haircut right here. All right. So he has the alt-right cut going. So now, he did an interview lying his fucking ass off. Now, understand, when I debated him, he was lying his ass off during the debate. Understand, when I was debating him, I was whooping his ass so bad, and Andrew is still salty that I embarrassed the fuck out of him on his own podcast. Because Andrew, he's one of these dudes who, his whole shtick is being the white guy who can talk shit around black folks. And I lit his ass up on an intellectual level, and he was reduced to lying. This motherfucker said, well, crystal meth is a new drug. I mean, he was just making up shit out of his ass. But he's still been kind of salty. The white supremacists, they don't like taking L's, especially from a black person who embarrasses the fuck out of them on their own joint. But this is him doing this interview with, not interview, but this is his show with Charlamagne.
Be it a Mark Wahlberg film.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? And then I love this new franchise. So, I mean.
I'm not surprised that it came from Tariq because this is what Tariq does. I mean, we had Tariq on here. This is what he's done in the past is he race baits, man. Or race pimps, I would even say.
What the fuck is race baiting? You know what race baiting is? Race baiting is calling out white supremacy. And watch that. Whenever these dudes start talking about race baiting, that's white supremacist talk right there. Race baiting is white supremacist talk. He's using all the white supremacist code words. Race bait is white supremacist talk. All right?
So important to get information out there, but people have to be receptive to the information.
Sure.
And when you get new information, you got to be smart enough to change your fucking mind.
Absolutely.
That's all I'm saying.
D-Ray did.
You got to do a D-Ray.
D-Ray found out new information and then backed off of it.
And by the way, he was ready to clap back at Whoopi.
Now, they're talking about D-Ray. A lot of people, because and again, I mentioned earlier, I'm going to get on that race pimp thing. I'm going to get on that. But with D-Ray, a lot of people punk D-Ray out because D-Ray acknowledged that, hey, this shit, y'all are kind of making this thing look like me, and they kind of punked him out. They ain't punking me out because I brought receipts. I brought receipts, books, articles, interviews of the original directors of Planet of the Apes themselves saying that the whole franchise is about race. They said it. The people who made the original Planet of the Apes, they were very explicit about it being about race. One of the directors said he was watching the Watch riots and he wanted to use that allegory from one of the earlier Planet of the Apes. I mean, these people said this. So I bring receipts. I ain't backing down off no truth. So you can punk him out. You ain't gonna punk me out with that shit because I'm bringing the truth. And the Planet of the Apes franchise has always been a racial allegory according to the people who made it. All right? Hold on.
First tweet was like, oh, if you got something to say to me, I'm here. But then I guess he really paid attention to right. What she said. He had to, being the smart guy he is, he had to fall back.
Well, and that's the difference between somebody who is right to lead a group of people.
Yeah. This is them trying to tell you who the leader should be. Listen to this white supremacist suspect ass. Listen to this. This is Andrew talking about the right person to lead somebody, meaning somebody who will back down.
And take their own words and be accountable for that.
Yes.
And somebody who is pimping a group of people.
Yeah.
Which is Tariq, right? Which he doesn't really care. I mean, I got to beef with Tariq because he put up this website, the Suspected Words website. I mean, it's already taken down, but he put up this, we were talking about. But, and basically, Suspected Words website, SWS, Suspected White Supremacist Database, whatever the fuck it is, right? And he put a bunch of people on this website. And
no, I didn't.
Bunch of people that he had, I guess, beef with, put me up on the fucking website, and the shit pissed me off.
He put a target on your back.
He put a fucking target on my back. Yeah. Just
no, I didn't. Didn't put you up there. There was no target on your back. There was no target. Your life wasn't in danger. It was a suspected words database. Nobody accused you of anything. I didn't put your name on there. You weren't no target. It's that I'm a victim too.
What happened with, you know, with Linda by the NRA, yeah, that kind of shit?
What could happen to Connor?
What could absolutely
like so Connor could be eating in a restaurant or work.
Oh yeah, boy, this
Mayweather boy.
Now who's gonna dance?
Fucking fool. Like, I'm serious.
What's the hurry? Swing on him. Shit, T.I. swung on. Well, that's a little different situation. That's crazy.
That's my worst nightmare, that you get into arguments. Now,
the suspected worst database put a target on his back. See that white victim bullshit he's trying to run?
Little skinny ass motherfucker, and he's real like, oh shit, he got cauliflower on his head. Let me leave him the fuck alone. That might be a fucking MMA fighter.
Listen, like, swing, you best not miss.
Man, I'm not that. Can you know how bad an MMA fighter will embarrass you? Because they're going to put you in them grapple holes.
And you know what's interesting about that narrative? Oh, God, you put a target on my back. Oh, there's a target on my back. These assholes make videos. You putting a target on my back. If that's the case, the shit you're talking now, that's a target on my fucking back. Saying I'm a race pimp and a race beta. If we're going there, you're the target on my fucking back. Because people listen to these interviews all the time and literally email me with death threats. People listen to those interviews and email me death threats every fucking day. But I digress. I don't be like, oh my God, there's a target on my back. I'm like, shit. All right, but whatever. All right. All right.
You're going to sleep somebody.
Man.
You're going to have to tap out in a fight.
No, I got time for that.
Anyway, the point is, it's just, you have to understand the context of who's saying a situation, right? If you know that somebody is out there race baiting or out there pimping, by the way, with this website, the reason I know is the ultimate pimping is the idea was you could post to the website suspected white supremacists. So you could post whoever
you want.
Mars up there, all these people are up there, right? You post whoever you want. We looked a little deeper into the website, people started screenshotting shit. Now you would think that if you really cared about your people, you could just post whoever you want. It would be very easy to post because you care about your people. You want to get these white supremacists out there so you can get the word
out.
But
it wasn't about white supremacy, though. And all, on the site, there were options. You had to choose certain options, so you couldn't call nobody no white supremacists on there. You had to talk about specifically what they said. All right?
About your people. You would think that you wouldn't charge people to post them because that would just inhibit these faces from getting on the website and inhibit progress. And inhibit
what's the charge for a white supremacist?
$20 a month.
That's
to post
reasonable.
White supremacists.
$29.
So my point is,
it was a charge on there to stop so many trolls from going on there. That was the only reason we were charging was to stop trolls from going on there. That would deter trolls from making a bunch of different screen names and getting on there, fucking everything up, which they did anyway. But I digress.
You went from pimping girls. Oh. Now you pimping your own people. You're pimping black people. That's what you do.
Oh.
Or allegedly pimping girls, et cetera.
Allegedly. Oh, okay. Let's whoa. Andrew Schultz, and I know you're listening. I only had one hoe ever in my life. That was Grandma Schultz. That was your grandmother. Allegedly. Andrew Schultz, I only had one bitch that I put on a stroll. That was Grandma Schultz. That's the only hoe I ever had in my life. And that was a good bitch. I only had one hoe. I had that hoe for years. Your grandmother, Grandma Schultz, was my bottom bitch. I got that hoe. Your grandma had one leg, nigga. She was a one-legged hoe. Do you know what her name was? Eileen. Get it? And when I took the bitch to Asia, guess what they called her? Irene. Get it? Ba-do-boops. Use that in your bullshit comedy routine. But your mom, your grandma, that was my only hoe. Good bitch, though. Grandma Schultz was a bad money-making bitch. She helped me produce my Wash Your Ass album. And she was going to sing on it, but the bitch couldn't really vocalize. I'm like, bitch, get in the studio. She was like, it's hard out here for a pimp. I said, bitch, get back on the track with your one-legged ass. She couldn't say it was hard out here for a pimp the way I wanted her to say it. Nigga, so tell Grandma Schultz I said thank you. Allegedly. Allegedly. Tell Grandma Schultz I said, tell Eileen Schultz I still got love for her. All right? All right, let me play the rest of this bullshit.
Where this message comes from.
I'm going to be honest with you, man. If you pay $29 to post a picture of Andrew Schultz on a website to say he's a suspected white supremacist,
they would have done it for $15.
You, my friend, are right. Fuck media page. Like, why would you pay $29 to post a picture of somebody on a white supremacist website? Like, that makes no sense to me.
Guys, it's Asalama Andy. If you're going to post me, you got to post me right, okay? You post me and Linda Sarsour, okay? We are brothers and sisters under God.
The moral of the story is we all got to start having, like we say it all the time, got to start having more conversations with people, mm-hmm. start communicating with people more, and we all got to get smarter. Because there's a lot of shit that we simply don't know, and it's okay to motherfucking learn. I learned a lot this mm-hmm. week. I had no
idea. We learned your boys were suspected white supremacists.
Blue Vest and fucking Planet of the Apes in 1968. Mm-hmm. I had no idea that jihad had a bunch of different meanings. Mm-hmm. And I educated people by letting them know that boy is a white racist word. Mm-hmm. That's the way the world should fucking work.
Absolutely. I remember I immediately called Tariq.
Listen to this.
Once I, not immediately, but I saw this thing pop up. People are sending me on Twitter. I tried to go to the website. It was already shut down within minutes. And I called Tariq because that's usually how I handle any kind of issue. If I have a mm-hmm. confrontation with somebody, I go right to that person. Mm-hmm. I speak to them directly, you know. And I called him. He called me back. He's like, "What's up, Schultz?" I'm like you don't know what the fuck is up. I go, "Hey, Schultz, how you doing? What's going on?" I go, "Tariq, what's up with this website right here?" We go. He goes, "Oh yeah." And I was like, "Why am I on this website?" He goes, "You know what? Wasn't my website. I was just working with those people and helping them. I'm very sorry about that. I apologize."
That's a motherfucking lie. "I'm sorry. I apologize." Apologize for what? I didn't put your name on there. So what was there to apologize for? I didn't put you on there. So why would I apologize for something I didn't do? I didn't put your name on there. I wasn't on there. I'm sorry. You got me sound like a coon almost. "I'm sorry. I apologize." Does that sound like some shit I would do or say? All right, hold on.
Stand by your shit, Tariq.
Charlemagne. Charlemagne, do you believe your lying ass homie? Charlemagne, you the homie, but dude... Do you really believe everything these suspected white supremacists say? You believe I'm on the phone with this bitch-ass dude? I'm sorry, white daddy. I'm sorry. The way he talking. What the fuck is Andrew gonna do to me? That I would have to apologize and bow down to him. What the fuck is Andrew gonna do to me? But go somewhere and call the police if I yell at him. What the fuck is Andrew gonna do? You, Charlemagne, you ought to know better than believe some shit like that. What the fuck is Charlemagne gonna do to me? I mean, not Charlemagne, but alt-life Andy gonna do to me? Hold on.
I apologize about that. You know, I called him. I took it down because I don't want that to be potentially associated with me. People could possibly sue me, and it could be a bad look for me. You know what I mean? I was like, "Tariq, this is not only a bad look, but it's also potentially dangerous. Somebody could get hurt. You know, you put people on this list, somebody could kill them." So, or at least
he was talking about himself. Like, "Man, I can get hurt." He was on this. This nigga was sounding like a bitch who just had a miscarriage. "Man, Tariq, man, I'm scared. My life. Man, you know, this can be potentially dangerous." I mean, the nigga sound like a motherfucker who just got fondled in an alley. So I'm like, "Dude, you know, the site is down. I'm sorry. Get the fuck out of here." Now, Charlemagne, you know better. Now, he's a fucking bullshit white supremacist. Suspect. So I get him. But Charlemagne, you know better than to believe some stupid shit like that. "I'm bowing down to this motherfucker." What's he gonna do? If I say, "Yeah, motherfucker, I put your shit up there, now what?" What's he gonna do? "Oh, I'm gonna go get my dad's a lawyer, dude." That's the only thing he gonna do. "My dad's a lawyer." Bullshit. He ain't gonna do nothing. The fuck I gotta bow down? I told the truth. "Hey, man, I didn't put your name on there. There's some other shit on there. The site is down right now. You know, and there's some stuff on there that I didn't want on there because I'm I'm not controlling the site 100%, which is true, because there's some other shit that was happening. I didn't record the conversation, which I should have. And he most likely, he recorded it. Most likely, he recorded it. But hold on.
And now you're responsible for that. Yeah, is that what you want there? No, no, listen, I apologize. I'm very sorry. You know, I didn't have anything to do with it. This is publicly posted. People posted. People. I didn't have anything.
See, all that, I apologize. I'm sorry. Because, see, some of the stuff, he's mixing in some shit I said, which I said, this is public posted shit. But then he keeps throwing in that, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. All that I'm sorry bullshit is what's getting me.
Granted, everybody on this list has had some sort of beef with Tariq. There's all these YouTubers that got him taken down off YouTube.
Is that real? Somebody told me he got taken down off YouTube.
He got taken down off YouTube because he was posting copyright infringement things. He was filing copyright infringement.
Which is a goddamn lie. These people were planning on taking my shit down a month ago. Right here, live on Ustream, a month ago, I showed a video of these white supremacists and coons sitting up planning on flagging my shit, flagging shit off Amazon, posting shit on YouTube. They were planning this shit. They've been planning on taking my shit down. So let's stop the bullshit, lying ass, suspected white supremacists.
YouTubers that were shitting on him.
Wow.
So what Tariq is saying, you talk about Tariq, all of a sudden he goes copyright infringement and tried to get their pages down. So they banded together and they called YouTube and like, this guy's posting fake copyright infringement.
Bullshit.
So they took his page down. That's why
lie.
He's restarting
wow.
over.
That's a lie. I posted the email that I got from YouTube. I posted it on Twitter. See, white supremacists, they see what the fuck they want to see. I posted, they were just flagging any video. They were community flagging my videos. So they were just randomly flagging videos. They didn't have no conversation with no damn YouTube. They were going around randomly community flagging videos. He's a lying piece of shit, which we all know. And I post receipts. I don't do the I'm white and I say so.
On his site because he's broke and he has to find a way to make money because he didn't have his YouTube page anymore.
Shit, I'm broke and I'm dependent on YouTube. Now, Schultz said, I'm broke. And I depend on YouTube money. Okay. That's this motherfucker projecting his failed comic ass. Schultz is a failed fucking comic who's eaten off Charlemagne. That's him trying to project his bullshit onto me. White supremacist suspects always wishing somebody is broke like them. Because you haven't made whiteness work for you. You eating off black folks. Charlemagne is carrying you. If it wasn't for Charlemagne, you'd just be another hack fucking comic, which you are. There's a reason why you're doing these bullshit-ass comedy shows in these hole-in-the-wall spots over in butt-fuck Hoboken, New Jersey at Titty Twister's Comedy Club in Tucson, Arizona. All these little bullshit-ass comedy clubs, nigga. Your career ain't shit. You a third-rate hack fucking comic doing shitty bullshit club gigs. You got to go to Yuck Yucks in New Mexico to make you a couple of hundred fucking dollars. He's a fucking hack comic. Charlemagne is giving you life, nigga. And what happens with these dudes, these white supremacist suspects, who fail at other shit. Notice they start leaning over to that white nationalism bullshit. Whenever your career in the dominant society, a lot of these dudes, when their career is fucked up, they start easing over to that white nationalist race bullshit. Like Bill O'Reilly, Glenn Beck, all of these dudes were rejects. These dudes were ass out of legitimate journalism. Then they found a new life over at like Fox News, that Negro bashing. There's a whole new life to that. Geraldo was done. Geraldo's career was in the shitter. He was so delegitimized with reputable media. So he eased on over there to Fox News. You notice that when these Kid Rock, he's a washed up fucking singer. He ain't shit. He can't sell a real record. So now he's easing over. Ted Nugent is another one. They ease over to that white nationalist bullshit. Dennis Miller, ease over. He's a comedian. That money started getting fucked up in the game. He eased over to that white nationalist bullshit. Adam Carolla. He's another one who talks that shit. I used to be on Adam Carolla's show back in the day. Jenna Jameson, when she's too haggard and fucked up to sell that pussy, she eases on over here to the white nationalist bullshit. Tila Tequila. All of y'all failed fucking media people, y'all ease on over to that racist bullshit. You get your little alt-right haircut popping off. But that's what he is. Schultz is another fucking hack. A broke, bummy, loser fucking comedian who's a fucking reject. And they gotta start caping onto that white nationalist shit. And they love to project their own shit. You're race baiting. You're race baiting to make money. You're pimping. Everything I touch makes paper. Even before I was doing my Hidden Colors movies, my lectures were sold out. Go look at the videos. All my lectures were sold out, even when I was just talking about dating and relationships. I touch shit and I make it pop off. I know how to brand shit. That's why my video game is number one. Everybody go get Crispy's Biscuits. I had the number one video game last week on Google Play. It was a video game. Number one game. Got four number one movies. I'm not playing in Coochie Lips, North Carolina. I'm not playing in no bullshit-ass clubs there. at Yuck Yucks. You dig? So for him, he's been doing that whole little white nationalist bullshit, using all of those white nationalist talking points. And the fact that I got on his show and lit his goddamn ass up, he had a bug in his ass about that ever since. We play some more of this punk bitch.
Right? I don't understand what else he does for a living.
Tariq, I don't know if you're broke or not, but at Andrew Schultz is his Twitter.
None of his goddamn business. None of your motherfucking business. See, that's the thing. White supremacist suspects always want to be up in a nigga's bag. You notice that? And that's what he was doing. He thinks that I'm going to get on here like, I ain't broke. I got money here. I got money there. I do this. No, I ain't about to do that. If I'm broke, goddamn it, I'd be broke then. I ain't about to sit up here and start breaking down my financials so you white supremacist suspects can sabotage it and come up with ways to get at it. That's rule number one in the game. You hide your paper. You ain't got to tell everybody you'll get down. Notice that white supremacist suspects, they stay up in a nigga's bag. They love to find out what a motherfucker's doing to get some paper. If a black person's getting some money, the white supremacist suspects, they want to know where, who, how. They want to know. See, they like their Negroes holding the money up to the ear. That's how they like their Negroes. Oh, they nosy as fuck. White supremacists are the nosiest people when it comes to some money. You go somewhere where you look like you got a little paper, they're going to be all questions. I told y'all this a million times. When you get around suspected white supremacists, especially you somewhere where you ain't really supposed to be, like on vacation or somewhere nice, oh, they'll just strike up a conversation and straight up ask you, hi, how are you? Where are you from? So what do you do? How much money do you make doing that? Nigga, I told y'all, when I moved to my new office building, some of the other tenants there, boy, they don't pull no punches. They were like, hey, how are you? How you doing? And this is the trick. This is how they do. I want y'all to understand the game. They'll act real nice and real chatty, real talkative, and that's to butter you up so they can go on in with the kill. So, man, good to see you here, man. Welcome here. I mean, this is a very nice area. I mean, we have a lot of good times, and we go golfing, and we fly kites and all that stuff, so it's so nice to have you here. By the way, how much are you paying over there? Because that's coming. They'll slip that in. That's what they really want to know. They'll slip that in on you. Move into a neighborhood that's real nice, and you got some suspected white supremacist neighbors. Oh, they'll butter you up. Hey, Darnell and Lakeisha, pleasure. Great. Hey, man, welcome to the neighborhood, man. We got great school. There's a swimming pool down there. There's a Whole Foods around the corner. If you don't mind me asking, then you know here it comes. That's always coming. If you don't mind asking, how much did you pay for this house? That's coming. They stay in your bag, man. At your job, get a raise or get a position. Hey, man, you want to go to Chipotle for lunch, Steve? hey, man, hey, lunch is on me, bro. I got you for lunch, man. Hey, man, how you think those Lakers are doing? Yeah, man, that's great. Oh, by the way, I heard you got a raise. If you don't mind me asking, how much was it? The white supremacist suspects stay in your fucking wallet, man. If they see a Negro doing any kind of good, they want to know how much. Ola, I got my nigga Ola in here. I got Ola in here who can, and I talked about this before. When we did a movie down in Atlanta, one of the white actresses found out we gave one of the black actors more money than her. That white girl showed the fuck out. She called me and Ola for about a month talking about how come she didn't get the same amount of money. Am I lying, Ola? When that white girl, she somehow hustled some information and we gave one of the dudes more money and also we paid for his hotel because that's what we negotiated up front. She said, well, she told me that she lived in Atlanta, which she really didn't. She just kind of lied to get the role. So she drove over there and got her own hotel. We didn't know she did that. That's why we were only casting people in Atlanta. But we brought another brother in from New York and we paid for his room. And she found out that we gave him more money and paid for his room. She was like, what? How come my room wasn't paid for? Because they got to know how much we're getting and if they're getting more. If they're not getting more, oh, that's a problem. Yeah, and the dude was the main character. Yeah, he was the main character. And the girl, she got killed off in the movie early. So yeah, he's going to get more money. Yeah, we're going to look out for him a little bit. He was the main dude. No, the movie was over. No, you said I should have fired her. No, the movie was over. Yeah, she got the info from the main dude. The main dude was up here cupcaking with her. Man. But that little shit Andrew was doing, that's more suspected white supremacist shit where they want to stay up in niggas' pockets. They got him. I don't know what he does, but he broke. And that's supposed to be my cue to start talking about what I got, which I ain't going to do. He think he's slick. That's his cue to make an accusation that I'm broke so I can go on here and prove him wrong. Nigga, fuck you. The only money I got is from Grandma Schultz and her old school hoeing. I still got her hoe money left over. I'm living off that, Schultz. If you want to know where I'm getting my money, I invested Grandma Schultz hoeing money, nigga. I invested in Microsoft with that hoe money when Microsoft was the startup in the 90s, nigga. That's where I got my money. Allegedly. Oh, man. Okay, let me see if they saying some more shit on here. Let me play the rest. Hold on.
Know what I'm saying? You can reply to that immediately, but
yeah. Listen, man. What you need to do is reply to God. Because I'm with God right now. So you take this up with Allah, Tariq, okay?
The moral of the story for me with all of this is, man, is that we all have to get smarter. We all have to learn more about each other because it's too much real shit going on for us to be worried about.
I think that might be it. Let me see. Let me double check. Let me make sure he didn't say anything slick. Hold on.
Dude. You're pimping, bro.
Yeah,
they're trying to take your money.
Yeah, I just wish.
Wait.
You're saying a blue vest on an ape is D-Ray McKason? And you're putting that out there in the world like Tariq did? You're pimping, bro.
Yeah. So the truth is pimping? And again, I brought proof. All that, you pimping because I'm white and I say so. I'm bringing the truth. That blue vest wasn't on no damn ape just to be on it. There's a reason why they had that whole scene look like some Black Lives Matter shit. And I proved that the movie franchise was always about race because they said it was. So the truth ain't pimping unless the truth about me pimping grandma. Allegedly.
Trying to take your money.
Yeah, I just wish Tariq would have, and maybe he did, maybe I didn't see it, but I wish he would have just said something like, Whoopi's right.
No! You don't even stand by the fact that he made a what?
No, Whoopi ain't right. Whoopi was buck dancing. No, she ain't right. I'm not lewd. I don't have to impress white supremacists, dude. I'm not going to sit up here and lie so some white supremacists can be comfortable. That's what they're asking y'all to do. They want y'all to sit up here around white supremacists and lie because the lie makes them comfortable. Bullshit. That movie poster was a play and an allegory of Black Lives Matter. All that, well, the monkeys in the original Planet of the Apes had blue vests. There is no correlation for different color vests because there were different color vests the apes had on in the original Planet of the Apes. There is no correlation between that, them wearing vests and that, and the one ape with a vest on. That makes no correlation. That's no sense. They weren't paying homage to it. There was no correlation whatsoever. Zero correlation. That makes zero sense. What makes sense is that the original people who made the original Planet of the Apes said that the shit was about race and it was an allegory about black folks. That's either true or it's not true. What's pimping is motherfuckers lying so you can get butter biscuits. Come on now. I brought receipts. I brought the fucking truth.
Yeah. The second I called him on it, immediately, oh, there's nothing to do with me. Bro, there's a swastika on the front of the website, right?
No, it's not. That ain't no swastika, and that's when the white supremacists keep saying, that's a swastika, Tariq. But the thing is, when you ask them about the Keck flag, which looks like a Nazi flag, oh, that ain't no Nazi flag. So which one is
this image.
If my shit is a swastika, which is not, then y'all got a damn Nazi flag.
Sick, I'll show you guys the image. You just...
And the symbol on the suspected words database, that was the coat of arms for Kekistan. That ain't no swastika. That's the coat of arms for Kekistan.
And I go, Tariq, there's a swastika on the front of the website, right? Here's the image of the swastika. Okay. You see that, right?
I actually look like some sperm in a square.
Listen, that's what it is.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
It's not a swastika, but go ahead.
So there's this swastika on the front of the website. I go, Tariq, there's a swastika on the front of the website. His response to me is, oh, no, no, that's not a swastika. It might look like that. It might have something to do with it. But
no, I ain't say all that. That's bullshit. No, it may have something to do with it. Bullshit. I don't know. It ain't no damn swastika at all. It ain't no damn swastika. That's the coat of arms for Kekistan. That ain't no damn swastika. That is the coat of arms for Kekistan. All right? But this dude, Schultz, oh yes, that I'm white and I say so. I'm white and I say, that's all he's doing. Well, I'm white and I say it is. Now, y'all know I had the Coon Train, right? I'm gonna have to post up my Coon Train videos, by the way. But now, guess what I got now? I wanna introduce something else. I got the alt-right bandstand. Check this out. Hold on. Hold on.
Last year for the trolls. Oh, you gotta understand. Last year for the racists. You know they got a Nazi plan. Oh, maybe he's no Romeo, but he's no goddamn liberal. Oh, let's hear it for the trolls.
You guys are 13% of the population and commit 50% of the crimes.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
I'm not a racist, dude. I'm a race realist.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Blue lives matter, bro. Learn how to stop resisting.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Liberal policies have done more to destroy your community than
let's
racism.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Diversity equals white genocide, man.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Stop race baiting, dude, and take responsibility.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Black lives matter. They're the real racists, dude.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Worry about crime in Chicago, not racism,
bro. Let's hear it for the trolls.
You liberal cucks can't stand the truth, man.
Last year for the trolls. Oh, you gotta understand. Last year for the racists. You know they got a Nazi plan.
All right, there you go. There you go. Now, Andrew Schultz, I put you on the alt-right bandstand. Now, I was a part of that. Now, I put you on there. I didn't put you on the suspected words database, but I made sure your bitch ass was on the alt-right bandstand. Now, what the fuck you gonna do about it? Yeah, I'm telling you I put your ass on the alt-right bandstand, motherfucker. I put your bitch ass on there. I made sure you got a good dance routine in there, bitch. Now, what the fuck you gonna do about it? All that tough talk, yeah, on the phone, he was apologizing. Motherfucker, I put you on there with your bitch ass. Now what? You ain't gonna do shit but go tell Grandma Schultz to come slang that pussy for me one more time to get some more of this race bait money, allegedly. Because that's the only bitch I'm pimping. Grandma Schultz, a.k.a. Eileen, the one-legged hoe. Oh, I'm going to play it again later. I'll play it again later. Yeah, I called him. He was all apologizing. I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry, man. Oh, bitch ass. You better take your ass to the Giggle Farm over in damn Hoboken, New Jersey and get your little $200-$300 from doing your bullshit ass stand-up routine to get the fuck out of my face with your bitch ass. My God. Man, that whole alt-life movement is a motherfucker. Man. It's already, I got it on YouTube already. It's on my the Elite Way page. I already got it. Let me give y'all the link. Hold on. Now remember, when I did the debate with Andrew, when I was there debating him, remember, this is how he was sounding. This is a clip from that. Hold on.
Things I was listening to that I definitely agreed on. And there are other things that I disagreed on. And it was, I'm listening and I'm like, I'm going, okay, I wonder, and I mean this when I say you are a gifted fucking communicator.
Mm-hmm.
And I wonder if you
saw. That's how he was sounding on the phone, all right? All that old tuck talk bullshit, he was sounding just like that. He wasn't on some old rah-rah shit. You're gifted, man. Which I wouldn't. That shit went in one end right out the other, by the way. You're a gifted communicator, man. Then he get off the phone. He's Rocky fucking Balboa. All right? Phony fucker. Lying bastard. And Charlamagne, you know better than to believe. You know this motherfucker be lying, Charlamagne. And that's the link right there to the alt-right bandstand right there. That's the link to the alt-right bandstand. And his bitch ass. You speak so well, you're articulate, especially for a nigger. It was that type of, you know, that old backhanded compliment shit. And the white supremacists, they're very good at backhanded compliments. They're very good at backhanded compliments. There was a story where, I don't know where this was, I want to say down in Georgia, where a brother, he saved somebody from a car or something, right? He saved somebody from a car, and he saved their life. He was doing, hold on one second, hold on. What was the story? He saved somebody's life. It was a burning car. They got in a car accident. What happened? What was the story? What was the name? What was the gist of that story, by the way? He saved somebody's life. That's the gist of it. He saved somebody. I just want to get the whole thing of it. So instead of saying a good Samaritan saved somebody's life, a local resident saved somebody's life, the headline was ex-con leaves job interview to save somebody's life. I'm like, what kind of bullshit ass? You couldn't just give the man, you couldn't give him his props without a fucking backhanded diss. They referred to the dude as an ex-con, which had nothing to do with nothing. Ex-con to save somebody's life. Get the fuck out of here, man. No matter what, and this just, look, no matter what you do, no matter what you do, the white supremacists will still come up with ways to throw dirt on you. That's why I'm team black empowerment, dude. They're just too dirty. No matter, we got to stop tap dancing for them, dude. The white supremacists don't, no matter what you do, they're going to look for a way to throw salt on your shit. Ex-con, ex-prisoner, I mean, they're going to look for ways to throw salt on you. Even when they act like they're giving you a compliment, there has to be some shit on it. You dig? Yeah, that's still a nigga shit. And speaking of OJ, by the way, they're about to have OJ's parole hearing next week, which I think they might deny him. I think they want to make a big, they're going to televise it. So it's going to be this big spectacle where they basically make him bow down so the world can see. And they, I don't think they're going to let him out. They just want to make a big spectacle out of it so they can show them whipping him and denying him, giving him that reject stamp on live television all over the world. That's what it looks like. Which, the reason he's in jail, nobody in the history of America has been in jail that long for stealing their own stuff. So basically, they made a new law because of the I'm white and I say so law didn't work the first time. They made up a new law to get him on a double jeopardy, basically. You dig? The Kardashian documentary? No, I haven't seen that. You dig? I haven't seen that. Now, a lot of people were asking me about the Roland Martin interview with Umar. And I'm going to play a little bit of that. But yeah, Roland and the guests that he had, and I know this is kind of old by now, but they were, Roland and his guests, they were, and I've been, y'all know I've been going in on Roland for a minute, but they were tap dancing like heavy. It was heavy. Let me play some of that real quick. Hold on. Because the whole thing was about, Umar was talking about black people should date and marry black people, which is a great point. And the fact that anybody would, I mean, you can date whoever the fuck you want to date, but the fact that these niggas was caping to date interracially, it just sounded real slavish and Sambo-ish. But hold on.
Asian, posit non-traditional views, people will automatically start to question his credentials. How did he get this far believing what he believes in? Well, you have to play the spook who sat by the door. When I got accepted into those three universities, they didn't know what I believed
hold
in.
Hold on.
Got people talking. One of them dealt with your attack. Only talk about not getting your respect.
Hold on.
So, mm-hmm. Harry Belafonte. Yes, sir.
Wait. I'm really looking for the part where Roland went full bidip bidip. He went bidip bidip bidip. It was funny as shit. He went full bidip bidip. I want to find out what part, what minute mark that is. That's the part I want to find. Hold on.
Belafonte is a white wife. No respect for him? City would be very, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter your social status.
No. I didn't say social. I'm talking about the one who put the work in.
Right, but you put him out.
No. I'm asking you. So, mm-hmm. Harry Belafonte.
Yes, sir.
Sidney Poitier. Julian Bond. Vernon Jordan.
And you're naming all them to say what?
No, these are all African American men, mm-hmm.
Who have done some good things.
No, who married white women. But you said, any black man who marries a white woman will not get your respect.
Can I respond?
Yeah, go ahead.
And what I'm telling you is this. Still a country.
Where's
they
that?
Are.
Hold on.
What does that mean?
Let me break it down.
Hold on.
And read this before you school.
I'm trying to get the beep, beep, beep.
All right. But then, okay, she had Grandma Vivian.
Let me play the part where Roland got mad. Hold on. I got to play that part. Hold on.
About taking over I want a charter school. So you want a private school.
Exactly. Independent Lauren. School.
Lauren.
So the question of interracial marriage, come on, man. You're too smart for this. We got 43 million black people in this country.
And there's some lady on there with a damn Jerry curl on there, and her and Roland look like they've been sharing the same pink oil moisturizer. This woman has a fucking Jerry curl looking like Ola Ray from the Michael Jackson Thriller video. This woman has a fucking Jerry curl, nigga.
190 million white people, you're going to sit here and say that if a black person get married,
1050, okay, hold on.
Black person, white person hold get on. Married, one can't understand the other.
And there's another Negro here. This nigga's hairline is so fucked up. There's another coon on here. His hairline, I've never seen a nigga's hairline this fucked up. Y'all got to look at the video. This other dude, he's like a black Republican, so he's on there cooning. What is it about coons and fucked up hairlines? Like Stephen A. Smith, Crispy, what is it about coons with fucked up hairlines? This nigga's hairline is more fucked up than Crispy. That nigga hairline looks like a Nike symbol. It's so fucked up. It's like, they don't really hang around black people. No black person cut this nigga hair. A fucking Filipino can cut this nigga's hair to make it that fucked up. Now let me play the Badeep Badeep. Hold on. Let me find the Badeep Deep. Hold on. Hold on.
The auction company in charge of the sale that it was been sold to a developer.
So how much money was raised? What the people gave? All the people gave. How much was raised and what's the status of that?
Rolling with full but deep. Hold on.
Was raised what the people gave. All the people gave. How much was raised? What's
the... That nigga sound like he's about to beatbox. Oh God, rolling with full but deep. Sound like he was about to do a Dougie Fresh. Hold on. Hold on. Wait.
Yeah. In charge of the sale that it was been sold to a developer.
So how much money was raised? The people gave. All the people gave. How much was raised? What's the status?
$700,000 in
Okay, where's the part where Roland got mad? That's the funny part too. When Roland got mad. Hold on, where? Because Umar called old dude a coon and Roland went off. That was funny. Where's that part? Hold on. Wait.
Get our arms around that. That does make sense.
Hold on.
The intended gains of the civil rights.
Hold on, where is that part, man? Where's the part where he called him a coon? Umar called dude a coon, and Roland went off. I got to do a remix of that. He went full deep. Where is that? I should have had all this stuff labeled. Hold on.
It's difficult for me.
Hold on.
Systematically,
One second answer.
Can I finish?
Go.
Okay, I'm going.
Hold on.
Yes, we have individual struggle. Yes, we have struggles.
Here we go.
You call me a liar, and you're a coon.
Well, it's a fact that
you're lying.
Call me a liar, and you're a coon.
Well, it's a fact that you're lying.
Well, it's a fact that you're lying.
To say that.
Several things I don't allow. I don't allow the N-word.
Beep.
I don't allow coon.
Beep.
We can talk to one another and disagree, but I do not use racial epithets against black people.
That's fine, but he called me a liar.
No. Racial epithets will not
be epithets. What the fuck is an epithet? Epithets. Where's my damn Roly Owl? It's around here somewhere.
It was on this show.
And that's fine.
By anybody.
But how we talk to each other needs to be.
You can say whatever you want, but no racial epithets will be used on this show about black people. Eugene, your question.
That nigga S Curl starts sweating a little bit on this show. Well, the S curl started getting, it started sweating and drying up. Epithets. Ain't gonna be no epithets. What the fuck is an epithet? Man. Woo. That was some funny shit, man. Oh, my Lord. Yo, why does this nigga just give me so much material? Every time I try to get out, they pull me right back in. Oh, I got to do a whole new fucking skit. If he did this shit before I did the game, y'all know I would have had that in the Crispy game. I would have had that in Krispy's biscuits, nigga.
The epithets.
Oh, God. That shit is funny, man. Let me see who's on the phone. A lot of folks are calling. What's up? Who's calling?
It's Christopher.
What's up, Christopher?
Yeah, what's up? This is Tariq Show, right?
This is Tariq, man. Where are you calling from?
This is not Tariq. I'm to the Tariq Show right now.
Dude, don't call up here with no damn epithets, nigga. Don't call with no epithets. Don't call with no epithets.
I want to talk Tariq.
All right, nigga, get off the phone, nigga. All right. The phone number is 818-850-5404. Hey, family, listen to me. Listen. We're having a backpack giveaway. Ola, you know what I'm going to do? Ola, I'm going to call Renee. Who the fuck is this? Oh, this is my daughter. I'm going to call. What's up, sweetheart? About to leave?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Let me see.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Oh, yeah. Before I forget. Y'all know we're having a backpack giveaway next month. I'm going to... There's some places we're looking for out here in L.A. Let me give y'all the link to the GoFundMe page. We got a whole bunch of backpacks we're giving away for free back to school. We're giving some out in Chicago. We're giving them out in Atlanta. Let me give y'all the GoFundMe link because I know a lot of people want to get involved. Everybody right now, if you're listening, get involved. This is the GoFundMe link for the backpacks. We're giving backpacks away, free backpacks to kids in LA, Chicago, and Atlanta. This is the link right here, family. Share this link on your page. I'm going to call Renee at Shades of Africa in Long Beach. I don't know why I didn't think of her before. I'm going to call her, and we should be pretty good to go with her. I'm going to call her tomorrow. Where are my LA people? When does school start out here? Don't it start on the 20th, the 21st, because I wanna have the backpack drive before I go to Jamaica. I'm going to Jamaica to do. I got a thing that I'm doing out there, but I want to do the backpack thing early August. Just get it done, get it out the way, so the kids can have it. But that's the link. Everybody, there's how many people in here? Thousands of us in here. Everybody, put some on the backpack giveaway. Everybody put some on the backpack giveaway. So, and the trolls had the nerve to say things about me doing a GoFundMe. Well, I'm doing a GoFundMe, shit, for other people. I'm not doing it because I need the fucking money. People want to get involved, and I'm creating a way for people to get involved. I mean, we bought thousands, hundreds of backpacks already. We got a whole bunch of them. So I've already put my own paper in this thing. So that's the thing. I always put my paper in something. Then people say, hey, Tariq, how can I get involved? A lot of people email me asking me how to get involved. So I created a way so people can get involved. You did? Yeah, we talk about that. The African Union in Haiti. It was some bullshit behind that. And we talk about that in the movie. Speaking of Haiti, do y'all know there was a Haiti official? Damn, what is it? I can't think of his name right now. There was a brother who was a former Haiti official, and he was part of that whole thing where he exposed Hillary and all that stuff. Why they find this brother dead in Miami a few days ago? That's another, y'all notice all these black officials being found dead in Miami, or not just Miami, just found dead, period. They found this dude dead with a gunshot wound to the head, talking about it was a damn suicide. You notice this little pattern? Y'all notice that pattern? Black officials popping up dead all over the place, and they talking about it's a suicide? Man. Klaus Eberwing, I think that's his name. Yeah, that brother. A couple of days ago, there was another prosecutor down there, a black prosecutor found dead on the beach a couple of months ago in Miami. man, a judge in Chicago was dead. A judge in New York was found in the damn river. All of these are not coincidences, man. And they keep talking, a lot of these shits are suicides. Nah. Man. But we talk, a lot of people asking about Feminista Jones. Now, Feminista Jones, as y'all know, this woman has been trying to shit on me for the longest, for years. This woman has slandered me for years. She was slandering me a few days ago, come to think of it. About 5 days ago, I saw a tweet where she was just randomly shitting on me. She's part of, well, she's one of the leaders of Shea Butter Twitter, White Daddy Ass Kisser, Pretend Black Feminist, Kiss White Ass. She writes for like these suspected white supremacist blogs where they shit on black men. Her whole platform is shitting on black men, calling black men dusty, ashy, broke. Her whole platform is shitting on black men, talking about how broke black men are. She ain't nobody to really hear of. She's basically a Twitter troll. She shits on black men. That's just her whole platform. That man-hating, mammy bullshit where they sit up and hate on black men nonstop. She's the queen of that shit. Ashy nigga this, ashy black man that. So I mean, that's her platform for years. Talking shit about broke black men. How black men ain't shit. Yesterday, Feminista Jones was on Twitter begging people for $250 because she said her car got towed. She said her car got towed. She had some old bullshit excuse about why she didn't have the money, some bullshit about the ATM, some bullshit. What is this? Hold on. Who the fuck is this? Hold on. Hello? Who is this? Okay, yeah, where you at? Dial 07. Yeah. All right, sorry about that, guys. Hold on. Rock with me here. So, she's on Twitter asking, hey man, can y'all help me? I need $250. Can y'all send it to me on PayPal? Because my car got towed. I mean, she had so this whole long speech about her car being towed and she needed $250. And rightfully so, people were clowning. Now, some people, I guess some of her listeners or whatever, some of her followers were giving her a couple of dollars. And people were clowning the shit out of her. This woman is with at least 40 or damn near 40 on Twitter begging for $250. This woman is damn near 40 years old or over 40 begging for $250. White Zaddy, all that white Zaddy ass she kissed, white Zaddy wouldn't even give her no money. Hold on. So, she's on Twitter, an old ass woman, begging for $250 after all this shit she talks about black men. Black men broke, black men ashy, Tariq ain't shit. $250. You know what I did? I put the whole $250 on the PayPal, nigga. Nigga, I put the whole $250 on there. I said, on behalf of the petty, broke, ashy community, I'm giving you this money. I gave the whole $250. Now, she gave it back later. She gave it back to me later on that night because people clowned her so much. She gave it back. Because she was mad. She was like, that motherfucker had the nerve to put charity in the note. I did put charity in the note. That burned her fucking soul. I have to put something. I can't be throwing money out here all willy-nilly. I had to, for accounting reasons, I had to put charity. That burned her fucking soul. She said, this nigga gave me some money and put charity on it. I'm at home with the coon laugh. I had the crispy coon laugh. That burned her fucking soul. She was on there going, oh, she was like, oh, I hate him so much. Oh, Lord, dear God, I hate him with everything in my being. I hate him so much. Nothing would have burned her soul more than me giving her the fucking money. She could have kept it. Shit. That just destroyed her right there. Me giving her the fucking money. She could have had the money. I didn't give a fuck about that. You need to take it. Understand this. If you are a grown ass adult, damn near 40, and ask anybody, family member or friend, for $250, understand you going to get clowned anywhere you go. Anywhere you go as a grown old ass motherfucker asking somebody for $250 and you damn near 40, you getting clowned. Even if they give it to you. If you go to grandma, say, grandma, I need $250. Grandma, she'll get it, but grandma's going to go, she going to give you some life lessons. Y'all coming up in here, y'all laying up with all these men, ain't got no damn money. Out here, you got kids, and you're going to the club, and you're out here buying clothes, and you old as hell, and ain't got no damn $250. Go get my purse. All these men y'all laying up with, go ask grandma for $250 and watch what she's saying. Your ass damn near 40. Go ask grandma and watch her go off on your ass. She'll give it to you, but she's going to give you a lecture with it. There's no way. You ain't going nowhere without getting roasted for asking for $250. There ain't nowhere you're going to go, you old as hell, asking for $250 where you're not going to get roasted. You're going to get roasted no matter where you go. Oh, grandma will clown the fuck out of you before you go ask grandma for that $250. You out, grandma's gonna give you some real game. You out here. You need to ask one of these men you laying up with. You know, back in my day, we didn't lay up with all these men. Where's my checkbook? Grandma gonna write you a check. Man. You can't go nowhere. You can't even go down to the county building. Come on, I need some $250. They're going to be like, where your baby daddy at? Do you know your baby father? They're going to be going off. They're going to be asking you. They're going to have a fucked up attitude towards your ass. Well, get in the back of the line and fill this paper out, goddammit. They're going to be coming at you sideways. You can't go nowhere asking for no damn $250 and you damn near 40. Asking for $250. And you sitting on the damn internet all day running your damn mouth and you ain't got $250? And all these trollettes that's sitting up here trolling with you, they ain't holding you down? You can't get a payday loan without a motherfucker going off on you. Ah, damn. And what is, now, I keep hearing mixed stories. People are saying she's pregnant. Now, is she pregnant or not? Because somebody, I don't know what the deal is. Some people say she's pregnant. Some people say she ain't pregnant. Because that's what I was trying to find out. Because I'm like, if she's pregnant, let me find out there's a damn baby registry. Because I'm buying every goddamn thing on it. If she's pregnant, nigga, let me find out there's a baby registry. I'm buying cribs, playpens, bassinets, baby shoes. I'm buying everything on that motherfucker. Man. Lord. But the level of fuckery on her end is just, it's just ridiculous. Man. Say she gonna return it. Oh, shit. Like I said on Twitter, nigga, I'm gonna come to the baby shower dressed like Tommy the Clown. I'm gonna be dressed like Tommy the Clown and start crumping. Man, man, man. And make it out to charity. That's the thing that really got her. That was the thing that really burned her soul when I made the donation out and the note said charity. That fucking killed her. That burned everything about her. It was at this moment she knew life was just fucked up. You dig? And look, I was being genuine about it. She could have had the money. I don't want to see nobody fucked up in the game. I don't like to see nobody fucked up in the game. Yeah, I give you, you know, even if you're my arch enemy, I don't want to see you fucked up in the game, you know? Now, I'm going to clown. Now, let's, that's a given, you know. Oh, real talk, Zaria. Man. Man, man, man. Lord. Anyway, I got a lot of shows to watch, man. Let me play the alt-right bandstand one more time. Y'all want to see it one more time? Let me play the alt-right bandstand one more time. Let me do that once more. Hold on. Here's the alt-right bandstand one more time.
Last year for the trolls. Oh, you gotta understand. For the racists, you know they got a Nazi plan. Oh, maybe he's no Romeo, but he's no goddamn liberal. Oh, let's hear it for the trolls.
You guys are 13% of the population and commit 50% of the crimes.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
I'm not a racist, dude. I'm a race realist.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Blue lives matter, bro. Learn how to stop resisting.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Liberal policies have done more to destroy your community than racism.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Diversity equals white genocide, man.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Stop race baiting, dude, and take responsibility.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Black lives matter. They're the real races, dude.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
Worry about crime in Chicago, not racism, bro.
Let's hear it for the trolls.
You liberal cucks can't stand the truth, man.
Let's hear it for the trolls. Oh, you gotta understand. Let's hear it for the racists. You know they got a Nazi plan.
Alright. There it is. Man, man, man. Alright, y'all. I got work to do, man. I gotta, you know, do a lot of stuff, get stuff prepared for the giveaway. But everybody go to, put the link to the GoFundMe page on your page. Make your donation tonight to help these kids get these backpacks, man. We gotta start looking out for our own goddamn kids, dude. We gotta start looking out. Alright? We gotta start looking out for our own community, not just the kids. You dig? Man. So it's been real. Told you, tonight was going to be a good show. It was a good show tonight. We had a great time tonight. Talked about the alt-lice. Talked about bitch-ass alt-lice Andy. And just had a great time tonight. Anyway, go follow me on Twitter at Tariq Nasheed. Follow me on Instagram at Tariq Elite. Still working on these pages, getting them popping, family. All right? So y'all have a good